Hello there. A very good morning to you. Dr. Ilian Iliev is joining us today from NetScientific because you've said you've been fast-tracked for a possible license by the US Food and Drug Administration. We're going to understand what this is all about and what will it mean essentially for those patients and what the plan is exactly, because this is being developed by your portfolio company, which is PDS Biotechnology Corporation, and this is for the treatment of the recurrent or metastatic, as we call it, head and neck cancer. Let's talk about it some more. What exactly does this mean? And a very good morning to you.
Good morning, Katie. Thank you very much. And you're right, this is really a very exciting development for PDS Biotech. They've had an amazing year last year in terms of development with four phase two trials under development broadly in the head and neck cancer space, which is a particularly nasty and difficult area of oncology to treat. Yeah. Now, as we all know, while the company has developed well, it has been also buffeted by the winds in the biotech public markets in the US, which has seen its price share decline significantly. But I think this FDA fast track designation really moves the company forward one step closer to PDS's drug portfolio, making it to the market. And of course, what we all always need to be to remember that while we're all focused on the dynamics of the stock market, the ultimate measure of value in the biotech sector is not necessarily the price per share, but demand from patients, demand from physicians, demand from the healthcare system for life-saving or life-improving drugs. And PDS is one significant step closer to that. Now, what does the FDA fast-track designation means? The FDA gives this very relatively rarely to companies whose drugs are meeting a specific unmet need and have a significant scope for improving either the lifespan of the patients or indeed helping them to be cured. So it's a rare designation, and it's given only in very specific circumstances. So we see this as a major validation for PDS.
Okay. And what exactly happens now?
Well, I mean, the company has a number of routes that it can take forward. Again, it's not one phase two trial. They have several phase two trials. And within the current market context, they're in a very strong position. They have roughly $50 million of cash as of the last quarterly filing. So they're able to continue with their development program.
Okay. And you mentioned how vicious this is. Of course, it's devastating for people who have this, but I believe that head and neck cancer is rising as well over the past sort of decade or so. Just tell us how much of a problem it really is.
Well, it's a significant problem. I mean, it's from a market perspective, it's a multi-billion dollar market, precisely because there's only so many ways you can treat this. So again, from a market perspective, this opens up a huge market for PDS alongside other drugs, blockbuster drugs in the market, such as Keytruda. But again, the human aspect of this is that this is a rising problem alongside the rise of HPV cancer. So it's a really welcome addition to the potential treatments going forward. Specifically, what the results of PDS have shown, and PDS will be showcasing this in the ASCO conference in the US in the next few days. But they have shown a significant life extension of patients that were terminally ill. People that ought to have died are still alive. And this is amazing news.
Wow, gosh. And that's what it's all about. And you mentioned as well, just in your first answer, you said making it to the market. What does that timeline look like here, would you say?
I don't want to comment on that because it's the PDS CEO that will be answering those questions in the online presentations that that he provides. But once again, as a development stage biotech company, PDS is extremely well positioned for the way forward with four phase two trials, all of them with big brand names in the pharma space. Biotech is going through a difficult stage right now, a significant realignment of investor expectations with retail investors in the US coming out and institutions not quite in. But this is not crypto. This is not fintech. This is not digital media. This has the most objective impact we can possibly have, which is around saving people's lives. And ultimately, from a market perspective, the markets will recognize that. I'll say one more thing on that, that in the aftermath of COVID, the healthcare system as a whole has taken a priority in terms of further investment. And within that, oncology itself is a significant priority area. And PDS is right in the middle of that shift.
All right. Well, thank you so much indeed for sharing your expertise and explaining that to us. Dr. Ilian Iliev there from NetScientific here on Proactive Today.
Thank you.